Hello friends, in last class we studied about the electrostatic equilibrium. So when the flow of charge stops in a conductor, then that is called as a electrostatic equilibrium. Under the condition of electrostatic equilibrium, a conductor has some properties. In last class we studied three properties. One is the electric field inside the conductor is zero. Second one is the electric charge inside the conductor is zero and it resides only on the outer surface of the conductor. And third property is the electric field is always normal to the surface of a conductor. Now let us study this class. The fourth property, the electric field at the surface of a charged conductor is zero. The electric field at the surface of a charged conductor is sigma by epsilon naught, where sigma is the surface charge density. See, here we are using Gauss law. Already using Gauss law, we studied the electric field at a point due to extended charges like line charge, charge on a plane surface and spherical surface. Now let us find the electric field at the surface of a charged conductor, that is sigma by epsilon naught. Consider a charged conductor of irregular shape. Consider a charged conductor of irregular shape. Let sigma be the surface charge density on the conductor. This is the irregular shape of charged conductor. This is charged. Let sigma be the surface charge density on the conductor. Irregular shape is the problem. We know that the distribution of charge on a conductor that depends on the shape of the conductor. For irregular shape, charge distribution is non-uniform. So wherever the curvature is more, there is more concentration of charge. Consider a charged conductor of irregular shape. Let sigma be the surface charge density on the conductor. Let P be a point. Let P be a point close to the surface of the conductor. To find the electric field at point P, imagine a Gaussian pill box of small area ds. Find the electric field at point P. Imagine a Gaussian pill box. Pill box means it is a cylindrical box. Pills, tablets and what called pills. Other box mode hang here at the cylindrical level. So antarunga Gaussian surface on the imagine monopoly and containing the pointer P. So this pill box lies partly inside and partly outside the charger conductor. In a explain. Consider a charger conductor of irregular shape. Let sigma be the surface charge density on the conductor. Let P be a point close to the surface of the conductor. To find the electric field at point P, imagine a Gaussian pill box of small area ds and containing the pointer P. Then find out this pill box lies partly inside and partly outside the conductor. Now find out the total electric flux through this Gaussian pill box. So we know that electric flux phi is equal to E ds cos theta. So small area considered made in the small flux agatha d phi equals to E into ds cos theta. So this Gaussian pill box that has three surfaces, two plane surfaces, one inside and one outside the conductor, and one third one is a curved surface. Now find out the electric flux through the plane surface inside the conductor. That is zero because it does not enclose any charge. Hence electric field inside the charged conductor is zero. E zero agatha, zero into anything is zero. Electric flux through the plane surface inside the conductor is zero. In the electric flux through the curved surface, we know that the direction of electric field is always normal to the surface of a conductor. This is the direction of electric field. So in area vector considered is normal drawn to the curved surface is perpendicular to the electric field. Theta 90 degree agatha, cos 90 is 0. So therefore electric flux through the curved surface is 0. Now electric flux through this plane surface outside the conductor. Here if we draw the normal to this plane surface, that is along the electric field agatha, area vector and electric field both are in the same direction. Theta is 0 degree agatha, cos 0 degree is 1 into E ds. Therefore total electric flux, total electric flux through pill box is phi is equal to E into ds. Electric flux through plane surface inside the conductor and curved surface of pill box is 0. So electric flux through plane surface outside the conductor containing point P is phi equals to E into ds. So therefore total electric flux through the entire pill box is phi equals to E into ds. According to Gauss theorem or Gauss law, total electric flux through any closed surface is Q by epsilon naught, that is equals to sigma ds divided by epsilon naught. This is because sigma equals to Q divided by ds. The surface charge density is defined as a charge per unit area. Therefore, Q equals to the sigma into ds. Equating both, therefore, E into ds is equal to sigma ds divided by epsilon. Ds, ds get cancels. Therefore, electric field E equals to sigma divided by epsilon. Electric field at the surface of a charged conductor is a sigma by epsilon. This is for any shaped charged conductor. Okay. Next one. The electric potential everywhere inside the conductor constant everywhere inside the conductor, surface of the conductor, and it is same as that of the its surface. This is quick property when the air conductor is in electrostatic equilibrium. Already you studied this. Electric potential due to a spherical cell. There we studied electric potential at three points. First one is electric potential at a point outside the spherical cell, that is V is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q divided by R, where R is the distance of the pointer from center O of the sphere. Second one is electric potential on the surface of a charged spherical cell is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q divided by capital R, where R is the radius of the spherical cell. And the third point one is electric potential at any point inside the surface of a charged spherical cell is also V is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q divided by R. There we stated that the electric potential inside the charged spherical cell is constant and it is its value is same as that on its surface. Now let us see how it is. The electric potential is constant everywhere inside the conductor and it is same as that on its surface. The electric field at any point is given by using relation between electric intensity and electric potential E is equal to minus dV by dr. So dV by dr is rate of change of potential with distance called a potential gradient. E is electric field. But E is equal to 0 inside the conductor. Inside the surface of a conductor, E is zero. The electric field inside the surface of a charged conductor is zero. Therefore, zero is equal to minus dV by dr, or dV is equal to V. This implies V is equal to constant. E equals to minus dV by dr, but inside the conductor E is zero. E the zero substitute markotini. Zero is equal to minus dV by dr. Cross multiply markoli dV is equal to zero. Agatha dV means change in potential is zero. Means potential is not changing, it remains constant. The electric potential is constant everywhere inside the conductor, and it is same as a that on its surface, the surface of the conductor. Surface of the conductor that is the potential irutte inside the yavade point at the center of the conductor consider madidru saitha potential constant irutte. But so this potential decreases with the distance for a point outside the conductor. Okay, this is the fifth property. Now let us study the another concept, that is electrostatic shielding. Electrostatic shielding. Consider a conductor, charged conductor with cavity without any charge in the conductor. This conductor is placed in an external electric field. When any conductor consider markoli, this is one charged conductor. So with some cavity, it is cavity. See cavity. This is some region of space inside the conductor. It may be hollow. So a cavity, it is that the conductor na consider markoli without any charge inside the cavity. This cavity or any other charge irbaru. It is a charged conductor. So if this conductor is placed in an external electric field, illonne external electric field valiya place madidri anta a electric field may be uniform or non uniform, e external, the electric field inside the conductor is zero. You know that for any charged conductor electric field is zero inside the conductor. But this conductor is placed in an external electric field. Inside the conductor electric field is zero. Now this cavity is shielded from outside electric field. This conductor anna external electric field or place martila, but this cavity anirutha inside conductor, so it is not affected by any external electric field. So it is totally shielded from outside electric field. So this phenomenon is known as electrostatic shielding. The cavity which is shielded from external electric field is called as a Faraday cage. ಈ ಕ್ಯಾವಿಟಿ ಅನ್ನು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟರ್ನಲ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ಅಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಇದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಏನು ಆಗಲ್ಲ, ಆ ಕ್ಯಾವಿಟಿ ಏನಂತ ಅಂತ ಫೆರಡೆ ಕೇಜ್. ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಒನ್ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ಡ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟರ್, ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಅ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ಡ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟರ್ ವಿತ್ ಕ್ಯಾವಿಟಿ ವಿಥೌಟ್ ಎನಿ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಇನ್ ಸೈಡ್ ದಿ ಕ್ಯಾವಿಟಿ. ಒಂದು ಕಂಡಕ್ಟರ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಅದರೊಳಗೆ ಕ್ಯಾವಿಟಿ ಇರಬೇಕು. ಸೊ ಇದರ ಏನು ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಇರಬಾರ್ದು. Now this conductor is placed in an external electric field. External electric field will place one. The electric field inside the conductor is zero. Conductor na external electric field will place one, but inside the charge of conductor electric field is zero. You know that. Now this cavity is sealed or protected from external electric field or outside electric field. This is known as electrostatic shielding. It can be known electrostatic shielding. Then the cavity which is shielded from external electric field is called as a Faraday cage. In hantam cavity ye antyo Faraday cage. Now define electrostatic shielding. The phenomenon of protecting a certain region of space from external electric field is called as a electrostatic shielding. The explanation is why cavity is protected from external electric field. So this phenomenon is called as electrostatic shielding. The phenomenon of protecting certain region of space from external electric field is called as a electrostatic shielding. Okay. Now let us see the applications. Applications of electrostatic shielding. Idha definition namma sikya tara. मतलब मासी के इन्हीं मन एप्लीकेशन क्या है? तू मासी के इधर डेफिनेशन है ना वन एप्लीकेशन. ओनली वन मासी के इधर डेफिनेशन क्या है? सो सी फर्स्ट एप्लीकेशन. ड्यूरिंग लाइटनिंग रेन आती दागा गुड़गुमिन चेन बरत सीडी लोडिंग वाला लाइटनिंग है. ड्यूरिंग लाइटनिंग इट इज सेफर टू सिट inside a car rather than near a tree. ಮಳೆ ಆಗ್ತಿದ್ದಾ ನೋಡಿ ಗಿಡದ ಕೆಳಗೆ ಮೇಲೆ ಬರ್ರಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಿರ್ತಾರೆ. ಯಾಕೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾ? ಸೊ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸಿಡಿಲು ಹೊಡಿತದಲ್ಲ, ಸಿಡಿಲು ಹೊಡಿತಪ್ಪ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಗಿಡಕ್ಕೆ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಹೊಡಿತದ, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಅಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗತ್ತೆ. ಅದ್ರ ಸಂಬಂಧ ಯಾವ್ದಾರ ಒಂದು ಮೆಟಾಲಿಕ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಒಳಗೆ ಕಾರ್ ಇರ್ಬೋದು ಬಸ್ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಆ ಮೆಟಾಲಿಕ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಒಳಗೆ ನೀವು ಕುಂತೀರಿ ಅಪ್ಪ ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ಸೊ ಆ ಲೈಟಿಂಗ್ ಏನಾಗತ್ತಲ್ಲ ಅದರ ಇಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆ ಕಾರ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಆಗಲ್ಲ ಅಥವಾ ಬಸ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಆಗಲ್ಲ. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಮನೆಯೊಳಗೆ ಮೊದಲು ಮಳೆ ಆಗ್ತಿದ್ದಾಗ ಹಳ್ಳಿಯೊಳಗೆ ನೀವು ಹೋದ್ರೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗತ್ತೆ, ಮಣಿ ಹೆಬ್ಬಾಗಲೇ ಇರ್ತದಲ್ಲ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಒಂದು ಕಬ್ಬಿನ ತೊಂದು ಹೋಗಿತ್ತಿದ್ವಿ, ಕಬ್ಬಿನ ಹಾರಿಯನ್ನ ಅಡ್ಡ ಹಾಕ್ತಿದ್ವಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಸಿಡಿಲಿನ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಬಾರ್ದು ಅಂತ. ನೋಡಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ಲೈಟ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೇಫರ್ ಟು ಸಿಟ್ ಇನ್ಸೈಡ್ ಎ ಕಾರ್ ರ್ಯಾದರ್ ದನ್ near a tree. The metallic body of the car so that protects the person inside the car from lightning, that is acts as a Faraday cage. The metallic body of the car acts as a Faraday cage that protects the person inside the car from lightning. Second application. The sensitive components of electronic devices are covered with a metallic body or shielded with a metallic cover or metallic body or metallic surface. So that acts as a electrostatic shielding or that acts as a Faraday cage. Sensitive components of electronic devices, lightning athwa aagtittu athwa heavy current bantu appa andre, so alle avu damage aagu chances irutte. So athwa bare external electric field alli induce aitappa andre, so avu damage aagu chances irutte. Adukka the sensitive components anna covered with metal case or metal cover, so that protects from external electric field. These are the two applications of electrostatic shielding. Let's see the dielectrics and polarization. Dielectrics and polarization. First thing, what are dielectrics? Dielectrics are nothing but insulators which affect the electric field in which they are placed. Dielectrics are insulators, means they do not conduct the electric current through them, or insulators. But these dielectrics, they affect the electric field in which they are placed. Means, you know, ee dielectrics anna external electric field olage ittaga aa electric field ge affect maartava anta insulators ge antara dielectrics. Dielectrics are nothing but the insulators which affect the electric field in which they are placed. Example for dielectrics are paper, ये माइका, प्लास्टिक एटसेट्रा. माइका डायलेक्ट्रिक आगत है, वाटर डायलेक्ट्रिक आगत है, अल्कोहल डायलेक्ट्रिक आगत है, ये इज ऑल्सो डायलेक्ट्रिक, पेपर इज ऑल्सो डायलेक्ट्रिक. एग्जाम्पल फॉर डायलेक्ट्रिक सर वाटर, माइका, अल्कोहल, पेपर, ये एटसेट्रा आर दी डाइलेक्ट्रिक्स. So these dielectrics, they contain two types of molecules. One is polar molecules and another one is non-polar molecules. The molecules of the dielectrics are of two types, polar molecules and non-polar molecules. Center of negative charge and positive charge do not coincide are called polar molecules. In polar molecules, there is a definite separation between the negative and the positive charge, and hence they behave as a dipoles and have permanent dipole moments. Example for polar molecules are HCl, water means H2O, alcohol, NH3, etc. These are polar molecules. H plus and Cl minus ions. H plus hydrogen plus ion, chlorine minus ion. They are separated by small distance, so it is a polar molecule. Okay. Now let us see what are non-polar molecules. A molecules in which the center of positive charge and the center of negative charge coincide are called non-polar molecules. If a molecule is there, if a negative and positive charge are there, one side coincide, one negative charge is there, and the other positive charge is there, both are coinciding. There is no definite separation between the negative and the positive charge in polar molecules. That's why non-polar molecules. Molecules in which the center of positive charge and the center of negative charge do not coincide are called non-polar molecules. In non-polar molecules, there is no definite separation between the positive and the negative charge. The positive and the negative charge is separation irala, distance irala le. Hence, they do not behave as a dipoles. Positive and negative charge of same magnitude separate are it matra adakke dipole irthe. But if separation illa andre, it is not behave as a dipole, and hence they do not have permanent dipole movements. Non-polar molecules do not have permanent dipole movements, but polar molecules have permanent dipole movements. For example, O2, H2, N2, etc. are non-polar molecules. These are non-polar molecules. Now, the dielectric with polar molecules are called polar dielectrics, and dielectrics with non-polar molecules are called as a non-polar dielectrics. Okay? So, now we studied dielectrics, and the molecules in the dielectrics are of two types, polar molecules and non-polar molecules, and also we studied what are polar molecules and example for polar molecules, and what are non-polar molecules and example for non-polar molecules. Now let us study dielectric polarization. Dielectric polarization. Polarization is nothing but one-sidedness, orientation of molecules in one direction. When these dielectric substances or slab is placed in external electric field, is called dielectric polarization. See, for non-polar dielectrics, now let us study the how that non-polar dielectrics they get polarized when they are placed in external electric field. Consider a dielectric slab with non-polar molecules. is dielectric slab with non-polar dielectrics. Means here positive and negative charges are not coincide. Sorry, they are coincide. Consider a dielectric slab with non-polar molecules. In absence of external electric field, external electric field zero it one. In absence of external electric field apply maadila andaga just aste slab consider maadidre andre. So in absence of external electric field, the dipole moment of molecules is zero. Hence, the dielectric slab do not have net dipole moment. Now, this acts as an insulator or dielectric. Good. External electric field in apply maadila andaga ee positive and negative charges coincide agirthava separate agala appandre they do not behave as dipoles, hence they do not have dipole moment. So each molecule they do not have dipole moment, but ondukku dipole moment illa andaga net dipole moment inside the dielectric slab is zero. Okay, now suppose this dielectric slab with non-polar molecules, when they are placed in external electric field, external electric field apply maadidri andre these negative and positive charges in non-polar molecules get separated. When the dielectric slab with non-polar molecules is placed in an external electric field, then external electric field is applied, or in presence of external electric field, the negative and positive ions or positive charges, they get displaced. Negative and positive charges in electrolyte molecules olaga ill coincide agirthavilla non polar molecules taga, but when by the application of external electric field these positive and negative charges gets displaced and hence induces dipoles. Now these molecules are acts as induced dipoles. These dipoles are induced dipoles. So idu dipole age behave maartu andre so it has a dipole moment. The net dipole moment is in the direction of external electric field. The dipole moments of all the molecules get add up to get net dipole moment in the direction of external electric field. Now the dielectric slab is said to be polarized. It is polarization of dielectric. Note, ella molecules one sided aagthavandre elladaru dipole moment one particular direction nag orient aagutte. Dipole moment p one particular direction nag orient aagutte. So ee riti aagutte antano dielectric polarization. Then these dielectrics with non-polar molecules is said to be polarized. One second. In absence of external electric field, the positive and negative charges in the non-polar molecules do not get separated. Hence, the dipole moment is zero. The dipole moment is zero. So, in the presence of external electric field, the dielectrics have been non-polar molecules in which the positive and the negative charges gets displaced and the dipoles are induced. These dipoles are called induced dipoles and each have dipole moment. The dipole moments of all the molecules add up to get net dipole moment in the direction of external electric field. Now, the dielectrics that have non-polar molecules is said to be polarized. This is known as a polarization of a dielectrics. Okay. Next class we will discuss about the dielectric polarization in case of a polar dielectrics. Okay.